Welcome to a new video. Today we're going to learn how to reset your ID in MySQL table to go back and restart from one. You know, you can create maybe thousands of IDs, and then what happens? Maybe you delete some. When you delete some, that number which is deleted is not replaced in MySQL. So once it's deleted, let me say we delete 17. When I create another one, it's gonna go to 18, 19. So it leaves that space. The system always leaves that space, and that's something sometimes you might not like to see in your program. You understand? So guys who are using MySQL and PHP, or MySQL and another language, I don't know, but that's the problem we're going to solve today. So go to localhost. If you use you're working on a local server, it's fine, or we're working on live server, doesn't matter. Login. Once you log in, for instance, we're gonna have a table here. I'm gonna look for one of the tables. Gonna go to employees table. We get that, we open that table. After opening the table, what's gonna happen is you can see the ID is 15. I'm gonna create, insert in two numbers for now. I won't put in the ID because it's auto incremented, so I'm gonna go here and put a name. It's gonna be Asm. Surname, we can say we can call send any surname, maybe Birmingham. Okay, I wonder if I got it right. So email address, we can put any email address at gmail.com. so once we're done with that, I won't fill in other fields. What I'm gonna go, I'm gonna skip and I go to another place where I'm gonna put another thing name. So what we're gonna go, his name is gonna be Martins. Okay, that's fine, guys. The email address is gonna be Martins at gmail.com. You know, Gmail is as popular as water these days. I don't know. So you go to another if you want, but I'm gonna save that for now and say go. Okay, I've created two IDs. I was gonna, you see, inserted row 17, two rows, which is goes until to the 17th row. You can see 15, 16, 17, right? But now this is the first thing in the table. Since it's the first ID in the table, you want it to be at least 1, 2, 3, 4. You don't want your IDs to start from that. So whatever you want to do, you can do it. Everything is possible. So I've seen a lot of people showing this answer on Stack Overflow, on other platform, platforms, but they don't explain this. This is what they don't explain. Someone's gonna say you do this, which is true, but I'm gonna explain why it doesn't work and why you shouldn't use it and why and when you should use it. So this one says, you say alt table, okay, then we're gonna put employees. Okay, this is our table. We put the table name, then we say space, then we say auto increment, which is this. Then after that, then we say equals to the value we want. Okay, say one. Okay, we give it a one. Okay, so once we give it a one, then we're gonna see put semicolon in, and then we're gonna do what? We're gonna try to run that code. Say go. The code runs 100%, no errors, no word. You saw it? I come here. Okay. And I click, but you can see nothing changed. Why? The reason is this code does not work on something which is InnoDB. Our DB is InnoDB, this one. So in the table is InnoDB, for InnoDB. So let me show you. It could work, I think, on my ISAM. Let me see, structure, relationships. What I'm talking about here is your table engine. The engine of the table, it shouldn't be InnoDB. That's why that code does not work on that. So we can also test it if you want on another table. If we can, then it will work. I believe so. But now I'm gonna run another code which is gonna help us to work. Also, that code works, but it doesn't work on InnoDB tables. So that's why I'm trying to tell people that the answer is right, but now they don't tell you when and where to use it. Don't use it on the table which has InnoDB engine. Understand? So I believe on my assignment can work something like that. So I wanted to show you something like to see the table's engine, something like that, so that you get, you see, operations. You can see this, our table is InnoDB. You can see this, the storage engine is InnoDB. So that's why that it didn't work. You saw. So if you go to tables like I got a table here called users, but let me first give you the password, which are the codes which gonna help you on these kind of tables. Then we're gonna take it from there. So this is the thing you're gonna use. You can see that the IDs never change, but we're gonna write a new code which is gonna unlock that key. So now what you do, you say set, let's make it capital set, space, then you say at, the at sign, then num, which is n u m, you can make it small letters, space, then you put colon equals to zero, then semicolon, then you say space down, space, can put another space, I put two spaces, then you say let me put it to be capital letters, update, if you say update, okay, space, what we're gonna get here, we're gonna get our table. In my case, it's employees. In your case, it could be something else. Okay, take that table you want to changes to be made. You make space, you say set, then make space, then you say emp id, you take the id, in my case is emp id, employee id, then we say equals to, we can put a space, we say equals to at num, which is gonna be small letters, num space, then we say colony equals to, put a space, then you put brackets inside, you put at sign, the at sign, then you say num, which is gonna be small letters this time, num plus, you use a plus sign, gonna be plus one. Okay, we put a one here, then after, by the end, we put a what they say, this. So after putting that, just know that we are fine. So once we find by that, we come down here and we can say alter table, we're gonna alter table, alter table. Okay, we can put that here. That, you remember what we did last time, you can say alter table employees auto increment one. Okay, then we're going to do this and we run our code. This is the code we're going to use. So after that, I'm gonna run the code, no problems, nothing. Okay, after that, we just got a simple warning here, but then we're gonna go to browse our stuff here and say okay. You can see our numbers have been changed to what, to 123, 123. You see they were 15, 17, whatever. So this code is the one we have to use on InnoDB. So what I'm gonna do, guys, don't worry, I'm going to put these codes on what, in the description below. And guys, if you like the if it didn't work on your table, comment and tell us which kind of table you're using, which kind of engine you're using. How do you see your engine? You go to operations, then you find this, you can see. So once you find this, you go here, storage engine, you tell us which engine you used. I'm gonna get you one table, I'll promise to get you guys. And though I won't change something because it's a little bit hectic there. I'm gonna look for users table. Let me go here. I wanna show you that the database, the engines are not the same. User, Okay, I'm gonna go to this one. Okay, I'm gonna click on what they call non-privileges operations. You can see on operate. Okay, also this one is InnoDB, but I wanted to show you. Okay, let me scroll down here. You can find the table which is under my ISAM. So this one, the first code could work on this, but it cannot work on this on the InnoDB. That's what I wanted to show you. Let me see if I can get one of those tables. If I don't get, it's gonna be bad luck for us, but it's no problem. So we're gonna come here back and we click and say user. Okay, I think I don't have nothing like that. I thought I had one, but yo, no guys, I don't have one, but it's okay anyway. But what I want to show you here is the first code we made, it can't work here. It can only work here, I believe, but the second code works here. So that's the thing I wanted to rectify, that some people, they put the codes and they don't tell you why you use this, why we don't use this. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe, and also please leave a comment if you have any comment, and if the code you liked it, please don't forget to do what? To share it on Facebook and Twitter and each and every social media. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.